Humber College, a place where young minds go to study hard in order to become what they want to be in the future. However, despite its academic success, beautiful structure, and high reputation, the campus has a much darker secret that's been buried in time. This humble little area was once the central asylum of Etobicoke, Ontario. The asylum went through many names over the years. However, it was opened on January 21, 1889, under the name Mimico Asylum. The construction of the asylum started in 1888. Hevis Tooley, the chief provincial architect, was responsible for preparing the blueprints of the building. Working alongside landscape gardener Samuel Matheson, the two created a cottage-like system with a combination of Romanesque and Gothic Revival styles. However, the construction for the system would have taken too long if it was just made by the city. So, to work around this, only a few buildings were completed. The rest were built by patients themselves. A way of cheap labor, if you will. Except these patients weren't paid a penny. Then again, if they had money, where would they spend it? Patients couldn't step outside the cottage walls. However, there was a bright side to this. At least, that's what the doctor said. They believed the patients' labor was beneficial to their physical and mental health. Whether this was true or not, it's still up to debate. When the asylum opened, it was the first institution in Ontario that exposed a new approach to the care of the mentally ill. This treatment was called moral treatment, and it was invented by Dr. Joseph Workman. He was the original brain behind the idea of wanting to make a mental hospital that did not feel like an institution. This line of thinking is also reflected in the blueprints of the asylum. Sleeping areas were labeled as bedrooms rather than wards or cells. The cottages also contained parlors, which were like day rooms for the patients. Around the buildings were different plant life and the construction of roads, walks, and bridges. There was also a gazebo and a pavilion near the original shoreline. The effect of this design was to create trees, park areas, and lake vistas, which were believed to have a calming effect on the minds of patients. The design also included dining halls, recreational space, various workshops, a chapel, and infirmaries. The cottage system was accepted due to the comfort it afforded to patients, being at the same time a cost-effective accommodation that could easily be expanded as needed, thanks to the patient's labor. The unfortunate thing is, this luxury lifestyle wasn't meant to last. On September 1, 1979, the asylum closed its doors. Despite an active protest from the staff, local residents, and even some patients themselves, the decision was finalized by Dennis R. Timbrell, the Minister of Health. The decision was based on troubles with fundings from the government, as well as the idea that mental health patients were able to benefit more from their treatment by living in the community, as opposed to being committed to an institution. After the closure, many of the patients became homeless. The most severely ill were transferred to the new Queen Street Mental Health Center, as well as Whitby and Hamilton Psychiatric Hospital. Later on, in 1991, Humber College signed a 99-year lease on the property, turning it into a campus that still operates to this day. Patients without any family and/or financial resources were buried to rest at the Asylum Cemetery, located at the corner of Evans and Honer Avenue, about 5 kilometers north. Wooden coffins were made in the past by patients at the asylum carpentry shop. After the closure of the hospital, the cemetery was abandoned, being consumed by weeds and garbage. Beginning in 2005, however, a group of volunteers came together to try and restore the graveyard. A large cleanup was organized, as well as hundreds of plastic flowers to mark the graves, a good handful of them without any names. To this day, the cemetery is still under the care of volunteers, who wanted nothing more than to show respect to those who were forgotten. Every time I visit Humber College, I can't help but feel sad or guilty. Knowing that this place housed over 1,000 patients who are now forgotten gives me a sort of eerie feeling. Do students who go here know that they are following the same footprints as those who were severely mentally ill? Probably not. Either way, we can't let the past haunt the present. Maybe it is time to move on, but never to forget.